What's up guys, Kim here of Fugatech, and we are in London covering the launch of the Huawei Mate 20 series. This is Huawei's biggest launch since the P20 series earlier this year. The Mate 20 and Mate 20 Pro are two of the most powerful phones released this year, and they both have so much going on in terms of design, hardware, and software. Alright, buckle up guys, because this is our hands-on of the Huawei Mate 20 Pro. But first, let's unbox this sweet phone. Huawei's most powerful smartphone in terms of its hardware, software, cameras, design, and battery. It's packing the Kirin 980, which is the world's first 7-nanometer SoC. It's also got a dual NPU, Mali G76 GPU, and LTE Cat21 connectivity. We also have 6GB of RAM and 128GB of storage, which is expandable via the new Huawei NM Nano memory card. The Mate 20 series are the first smartphones to support this new standard. And of course, we can't forget about the display. We have a 6.39-inch HDR OLED screen with a resolution of 1440 by 3120. That size with that resolution, it's actually crazy sharp. And under that display, we actually have a fingerprint scanner like Vivo has with their phones. Based on what we've seen so far, it seems to be also made by Synaptics, since it works very similar to Vivo's phones. It's running EMU i9, which is based on Android 9 Pie, which is a very rare OS these days, given how few phones are running it at the moment. For cameras, it takes on a similar setup as the Huawei P20 Pro, with a 40-megapixel main sensor, 20-megapixel ultra-wide sensor, and 8-megapixel telephoto sensor. And of course, the lenses on these are made by Leica. With all these cameras, you have pretty much all the focal lengths you need covered. Up front, we have a 24-megapixel selfie shooter with 3D depth sensing, so for security, we do get face and lock feature. Finally, let's take a look at the design. It's certainly not as pretty as the Mate 20 because of the wider notch, which almost reminds you of the iPhone X. Flipping it over though, we see that the entire phone is actually pretty darn symmetrical. And the back has a nice curved shape for easy, comfortable handling. It's also covered in glass that has what Huawei calls a hyper-optical pattern. This not only makes the phone look prettier, but also keeps fingerprints and smudges at bay and non-slip, which makes me believe it's specially etched in some way. And guys, speaking of pretty, this phone comes in so many nice colors like pink gold, emerald green, midnight blue, black and twilight like the one we have here. But having a glass back also enables wireless charging, which one thing the Mate 20 Pro does have that the Mate 20 doesn't. It supports 15-watt Huawei wireless quick charging, and it's actually also the first phone in the world to have reverse wireless charging. This means you can use the phone to wirelessly charge an iPhone XS, Samsung Galaxy Note 9, or any phone that supports wireless charging. Pretty cool, right? So now that we're on the subject of charging, let's talk battery. So it's got a 4,200 mAh battery that supports 40-watt Huawei Supercharge, which the company claims can get you 1% in 30 seconds or 70% in 30 minutes. That is crazy fast. But another thing that's crazy is this phone's price. which sits at a whopping 1,099 euros, which is almost 70,000 pesos. Wow. Do you guys think the Huawei Mate 20 Pro is worth that price? Is it your next phone? Let us know in the comments down below. And if you like this video, you know where that thumbs up button is. Consider subscribing to our YouTube channel for more content. Don't forget to hit that bell icon to be notified of our future uploads, and visit yugatech.com for the latest tech news and reviews. This has been Kim of Yugatech, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!